Alright guys, so ever since I seen the Dragon Ball Super Broly movie second trailer where we seen Goku's mother Gine, Bardock and pretty much everyone, from that point on I have been working on its story, and guys, today finally that story is done. And my inspiration for writing this story goes out to Dragon Ball Unguarded, because guys, on that fan-made story we got to find out about Frieza's mother. And without a single doubt guys, that story was pure brilliant. It was so good. And guys, today the story is about Vegeta's mother, KARIN. Dragon Ball Minus, which is written by Akira Toriyama himself, we found out about Goku's mother, Gine. And guys, for the first time in animation form, we got to see Gine in the second trailer of Broly. So we all know about Goku's mother and father, Bardock and Gine. And we also know about the father of Vegeta, who is King Vegeta. But we never got the story of the mother of Vegeta. Now this story begins with the death of King Vegeta's father. And as soon as he passed away, the leadership over all the Saiyans were passed on to his son, Vegeta, who became the king of the entire Saiyan race on planet Vegeta. Once King Vegeta got the order from King Cole, the father of Frieza, to take over a planet, and immediately the king ordered some of the Saiyan's elite fighters to go on that planet. But moments before the Saiyan elites were about to get out of planet Vegeta, King Vegeta wanted to go with them as well, which he did. When the Saiyans landed on planet Bikari, they started their assault, and King Vegeta told his military lieutenant and also the other Saiyans to spread across the entire planet, which they did. They followed his order. With the help of their tail, the Saiyans can easily transform into the Ozaru, but this time there is no moon around for them to use to transform, so they had to fight the old fashioned way. The other Saiyan elites were in a group of either 2 or even 4. But the thing was, King Vegeta got too prideful and he let his ego control him, and he decided to take on the group of inhabitants on planet Bikari all by himself. And with that guys, he was overwhelmed in time. He was being attacked from all directions, and no one knew where King Vegeta actually was, and even if they did, they wouldn't be able to help him because they were fighting their own battle and they were very far away from him. King Vegeta was being heavily injured by the inhabitants on that planet from left and right. There was one other Saiyan that was next to King Vegeta, even though he was very far away from King Vegeta, but still he was closer than the other Saiyans. But he could not do anything about it because he was also being attacked from all directions, and that person is King Vegeta's right hand man, military lieutenant Paragus. And he saw King Vegeta in big trouble, and with that he sent out a distress signal to all the other Saiyans that were with them. But no one was responding, and right now Paragus has only one option, that is to send a distress signal over to planet Vegeta. But the thing was, planet Vegeta was a bit too far away, and it would take the distress signal quite a bit of time to reach planet Vegeta. The device that Paragus was using to contact planet Vegeta with was programmed to alert any other Saiyan nearby. On a nearby planet, there was a female Saiyan who was sent there on a mission to collect data, to observe everything there, to see how strong the inhabitants on that planet were, and also the technology that they had access to. And the person that sent her there was Paragus. And as soon as she received the distress signal from Paragus, she immediately set course for planet Bikari. King Vegeta was being attacked more and more, and slowly he could not fight back anymore because he was so injured. And as one of the inhabitants on planet Bikari was about to land the final blow on King Vegeta to claim his life, the female Saiyan by the name of KARIN arrived moments before, and she saved the life of King Vegeta by using a weapon that was given to the Saiyans by King Cole. And as KARIN was loading the heavily injured King Vegeta onto the Saiyan space pod, suddenly from a hidden place, one of the inhabitants on planet Bikari launched a direct attack on King Vegeta. But before that, KARIN turned around and took the blast head on. And King Vegeta saw everything with his own eyes, and he was extremely shocked. Then Paragus arrived and easily blasted the attacker. After that, some time passes by, and King Vegeta is fully healed at this point. But KARIN, who saved King Vegeta, is still in recovery. Suddenly, the king arrived to see KARIN, and after he looked at her face, he realized that if she wasn't there, then he would have easily been killed by that blast because he was powerless and also injured at that point. Without thinking what would happen to her, she put her life on the line and then she jumped right in front of King Vegeta. Every day, King Vegeta came to visit Karin, and slowly they started creating a friendship. And from a friendship, they slowly started to fall in love. And one day, King Vegeta married Karin. After that, some time passed by. Then they had a baby, who as we all know as Vegeta. King Vegeta was very amazed from his son's power from birth. Karin loved her son Vegeta very much, and she wanted to keep her son Vegeta very close to her. But the father, King Vegeta, would not allow that at all, because he wanted Vegeta to become a pure Saiyan warrior. And King Vegeta felt like his mother's goodness would affect him in a very, very bad way. And Vegeta would show emotion and hold back while being in battle. Later on, after about 2 years, they had another child by the name of Tarble, the younger brother of Vegeta. But his power from birth was not that impressive. And King Vegeta is someone who is very, very power hungry. Since his new son Tarble was so weak, King Vegeta placed an order to send Tarble out of planet Vegeta. And Karin did not like that at all. And she told King Vegeta, "First you took away Vegeta from me, and now you're taking away Tarble." King Vegeta's response is, "Tarble is useless. There is no room for a weakling in this royal bloodline." As Karin is crying very heavily, she says, "You wanted a warrior, but all I wanted was a son." And the king's final response is, "My order is final." Now, two Saiyan space pods are being prepared for departure. One is the king's son's Tarble, and the other one is Paragus's son, Broly. The first one to go was Broly. The second one was Tarble. Both Paragus and Karin were running very fast to the direction of the launch of the space pods. They both come face to face as they look up and see their sons leave planet Vegeta and go to a different planet. Karin is crying very heavily. Paragus asks Karin, "Why are you crying?" And she says, "Brother, I have lost everything." And Karin tells Paragus about everything that happened. And right now we find out that Karin is a sister of military lieutenant Paragus. Anyways guys, that is about it. That's all I have for you guys. To do, let me know what you guys think about this. Comment down below. And this is not the end of this story. There is a part 2 to this story. And if you guys really want to know what happens on part 2 of this story, then guys, be sure to give it a huge thumbs up. And also, if you guys are brand new to the channel, be sure to hit the subscribe button, because guys, I'll be uploading latest Dragon Ball content. Anyways guys, once again, thank you all so much for watching, and have a blessed day, everybody.